Hello, my name is Rowdy.
And I'm Kelly, and we're here to take you through the branches of government.
First, we'll start with the legislative branch. The legislative branch of government creates our laws and approves proposed bills. It's made up of two houses, the Senate and the House of Representatives. Each state gets two senators, and the House of Representatives is based upon the population of that state. Wrong building. So, think. While we are here in Louisiana, we have 6 House of Representatives. But if you lived in California, you'd have 53 House of Representatives. Yeah, it's crazy, but it works. While each house has a large amount of people, they only have so many years during each term. The senators, they get 6 years in each term, but they can be elected for an unlimited amount of terms. The House of Representatives, they get 2 years, but they also have an unlimited amount of terms that they can serve. The legislative branch of our government makes the laws of our country. They create bills and send them to both houses to decide whether they should go on to the next step. But say a bill gets to the president and he does not agree with it. He has the option to veto that bill. And once he vetoes that bill, he can send it back to Congress where they can try to work on it again. So if Congress disagrees with the override, then they can send it back to pass a bill after the president's veto requires a 2/3 vote in each house of Congress. Fun fact, Congress has overridden fewer than 10% of all presidential vetoes throughout history. The judicial branch consists of criminal and civil courts who delegate cases and decide matters over. They also decide if something is constitutional or not. The major part of this branch is the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is made up of 8 associate justices and 1 chief justice. Each justice has a lifelong term limit, so they serve their term for the whole life. The Supreme Court justices are chosen by the president, but approved by Congress. This is one of the balances the other branches have over the courts. The judicial branch has the ability to call laws passed by the other two branches unconstitutional and stop the bill in its path. The judicial branch is an essential part of the country because it helps fix and establish problem-solving techniques to different cases with final judgment. Now we'll talk about our final branch, the executive branch. The executive branch is basically the president and his cabinet. The branch's job is to enforce the laws that are passed by Congress and approved by the Supreme Court. While the president leads the executive branch, he cannot do it himself. So, he appoints the cabinet heads. Each cabinet member is in charge of a certain department that handles national problems that involve that department. The president's cabinet includes the vice president and 15 executive department heads that he himself gets to choose. How cool is that? The executive branch gets its checks from Congress with their override and from the Supreme Court with their declaration of unconstitutionalism. The executive checks the others by vetoing bills and choosing Supreme Court justices when one of the others retires or steps down. Now that we've been through all our branches of government, let's get a quick recap. We have 3 branches of government: the legislative branch, the judicial branch, and the executive branch. The legislative branch holds our House of Representatives and our Senator. The judicial branch holds our Supreme Court, Chief Justices, and Associate Justices. And our executive branch contains our president and his cabinets. I hope you all enjoyed this video, but before we close out, we have a few questions. First question, who is our current president? Does anyone can answer that? Anyone knows? All right, for our second question, who is the most recent added justice? For our second question, who is our most recent Supreme Justice? Anyone knows? Okay, well, that's all we have for this video. See you guys later.